Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 22nd November, on the front page you have address every question on curbs. Supreme Court tells Jammu and Kashmir government. So, the Solicitor General has assured the court that situation has been beautifully handled. So, such is the terminology being used. So he says that there's no loss of life due to police firing. Then he says section 144 of CRPC has been removed from all 195 plus 7 in Ladakh police stations. Also, 802 incidents of stone pelting were reported in 2018, but this year there have been 544 such incidents as such, of which only 190 are after 5th August. He says all schools have opened, exams are going on as per schedule. And also hospitals and medical centers are open, medicines and food are sufficiently available. All landline phones, postpaid phones are functioning. So internet has not been restored, but all everything else is fine is what the government is saying in the Supreme Court. But this is only based on what the government says because no information is coming out of Jammu and Kashmir. Then this is Uddhav meets Pawar, coalition takes shape in Maharashtra. So Maharashtra is under president's rule presently. So Shiv Sena, NCP and Congress are working together to form a coalition government in the state. Then here you have Farooq Pragya in Parliament Defence Consultative Panel. So the former Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, a former state of Jammu and Kashmir, Farooq Abdullah, who is presently under detention, and Malegaon blast accused BJP MP Pragya Singh Thakur, they have been nominated as members of the Consultative Committee of Parliament for the Ministry of Defence. So this, presently the Parliament's winter session is going on. There have been questions raised on why Farooq Abdullah is not allowed to attend a session. He has been detained in Jammu and Kashmir since August 5. And now he's announced as part of this Defence Consultative Committee. Then below you have, India asks Colombo to boost reconciliation. So India has asked Sri Lankan government, the newly elected president, Gotabaya Rajapaksa, to boost national reconciliation policy with the Tamil community of the country. So Tamilians here are majorly located in north and east of Sri Lanka. LTT, Liberation Tigers of Tamil Eelam, was fighting for their rights because they're a minority. It's a Sinhala majority country. So they were fighting for their rights, and a separatist organization was formed in the form of LTT, but then it was eliminated. The LTT war ended it. But during that war too, many civilians lost their lives, and the atrocities by the armed forces at that time have to be looked into. And so that is one aspect. And other aspect is reconciliation. So now after the LTT is over, the Tamil community should also be taken into the national fold. So that is what India is asking Sri Lanka to do, that it should boost reconciliation now. And this is Bharti Airtel lost around 3 million subscribers in Jammu and Kashmir. So service shutdown has impacted Bharti Airtel in Jammu and Kashmir significantly. It has lost 2.5 of its 3 million subscribers in July to September 2019 quarter. And this is religion no bar for this professor of Urdu. So this is Urdu professor at Benares Hindu University. So we saw the Sanskrit professor, there were questions raised, how can a Muslim teach Sanskrit? But this is R.K. Sharma, who teaches Urdu at Benares Hindu University. And there is no controversy over this. Also there is, you can see Maulvi Mahesh Prasad, who is a scholar of Arabic, Urdu and Persian, who took charge of Urdu department as such earlier. So Banaras Hindu University has this history. On page 5 you have avian botulism reason for bird deaths. So 18,000 carcasses of birds have been removed from Sambhal Lake in Rajasthan. An Indian Veterinary Research Institute in Bareilly has confirmed avian botulism, which is a neuromuscular illness caused by a toxin which is produced by bacterial strain, as the reason for the mass mortality of birds, including migratory species from northern Asia at Sambhal Lake in Rajasthan. On page 8 you have Kerala to impose ban on single-use plastic. So it says this move is to prevent damage to ecology. And many states have taken up this initiative. Kerala has announced that there will be ban on production, sale and storage of single-use plastic from 1st Jan 2020. So plastic carry bags, irrespective of thickness, plastic sheets, cooling film and plastic plates and cups will be banned. So this is it. It also says that thermocol, styrofoam, disposable plastic caps, plates, cups, plates, spoons, forks, straw, dishes, stirrers, plastic coated paper cups, you know, plates, bowls, etc. would all be banned. PET bottles below 300 ml. Even plastic garbage bags, PVC flex material, plastic packets, everything would be banned. And violation of the ban would result in stringent action under Environment Protection Act of 1986. So you can see there's this body appointed by central government. It's called the district collector, subdivisional magistrate, officials deputed by pollution control board, secretaries of local bodies, and officials appointed by central government under the Environment Protection Act are empowered to take action if ban is not followed. But then the problem is that there needs to be alternative for any plastic item which is banned, and it should be an affordable alternative. On page 9, you have ISRO defers CartoSat 3 launch by 2 days in November 27. So this is CartoSat 3. So cartography actually means map making. So this CartoSat satellite is also related to mapping India. So it will offer 25 centimeter high resolution earth imageries. So it will be placed in a sun synchronous or a polar orbit of 509 kilometer. So this is the detail. It has been launched. It was planned to be launched on November 25, but now it has been delayed to November 27. Also, 13 small customer satellites from US are riding along with CartoSat 3 on Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle PSLV C-47. Launch will take place from Sriharikota. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Expedient Exit. So this is regarding yesterday's front page news on disinvestment. So the editorial says that disinvestment can only be a stopgap measure in plugging the gaping fiscal hole. So disinvestment will result in huge amount of money coming in the kitty of the government. But the editorial says that this is one time measure. So many PSUs, it was said, will be exited by the government. And this is to the power of two. So this is regarding Sri Lankan politics now. The Rajapaksas are back in power, the two brothers, Gotabaya Rajapaksa and Mahinda Rajapaksa. So they hold power, their hold on power should not undermine democratic gains since 2015. Is what this editorial says, because high-handedness of former president Mahinda Rajapaksa had resulted in population being favoring another coalition which did not last long. So now the brothers are back to power. Mahinda Rajapaksa did not become the president because of the two-term limit on presidency in the constitutional provisions of Sri Lanka. So his brother, who was former defense minister, is now the president. Defense secretary, was former defense secretary under Sri Lankan government, is now the president of Sri Lanka. Then the lead article is a blow against punitive constitutionalism. So it says Jammu and Kashmir High Court's verdict on Beggary Act rejects the state's fettering of guaranteed constitutional freedoms. So what do India's beggars law say? They first define begging. So begging is defined as having no visible means of subsistence and wandering about or remaining in any public place in such condition or manner as makes it likely that the person doing so exists by soliciting or receiving alms. So matlab beggary law actually tries to say that those who do not have means of subsistence, so for such the government has to make provisions. So criminalizing people who wander about, who look like they might need help, and they might need to beg at some point, It is evident that purpose of such provisions is not to protect public peace or prevent crimes, but effectively cleans these spaces of people, individuals who appear poor or destitute. So this is a strong voice raised against such provisions under the Beggary Act. And Jammu and Kashmir High Court's verdict on Beggary Act rejects the state's fettering of guaranteed constitutional freedoms. So this is important. The government has to make provisions for them. And this is a whiff of a new Arab Spring in West Asia. So this is, you can see Arab Spring is the terminology which was used for protests in West Asian countries. So the 2011 experience of Arab Springs is done with, but now there is another wave of protests which are being seen in West Asian countries. Even Iran is under protests. Iraq, there are protests going on. So in 2011, experience does not provide cause for optimism that spontaneous protests in Lebanon, Iraq can be sustained. So though protests takes place, but the solutions which come out of them are not long lasting, because they did not last long after 2011 experience of Arab Spring. So what does this new Arab Spring hold? We have to see what will be the outcome of the protests. On op-ed page on Fridays, you have this parlay coverage in which views, counter views are given. So today the question is, should we do away with subsidies for higher education? So this talks of inclusive and equity, which are very important characteristics of good public institutions. So for equity, we need to provide subsidies to those who can't have access. So to be inclusive, to provide equity, subsidies may be required. And this is at an inflection point. So this is regarding Mozambique. In Mozambique, warring groups need to embark on a path to stability following disputed poll results. On page 12, you have the protests which are going on in Lok Sabha on electoral bonds, which are being justified by BJP. We have been discussing about it for the last few days. And here you have only 4 out of 82 secretaries are from SCST community. So even elite IIMs have poor representation from these categories. So this is what has come forth in discussions at Rajya Sabha. And this is surrogacy bill referred to Rajya Sabha panel. So surrogacy regulation bill 2019 was referred to a select committee of Rajya Sabha. So several MPs raised concerns over several provisions of the legislation, including making it mandatory for surrogate to be a close relative. On page 13, you have violence shut down again in Sri Lanka. So police says groups of youths are making rounds of the city and calling for a shutdown by shopkeepers. So the Kashmir Valley is witnessing a sudden bout of violence and shutdown by shopkeepers just a day after Union Home Minister told Parliament that situation in Jammu and Kashmir was absolutely normal. And this is, you can see, the CRPF personnel patrolling a closed market in Sri Lanka. Then this is US rejected 1 in 4 H-1B visa petitions. So this is External Affairs Minister Jaishankar saying that he has taken up the issue with USA. This is a statement he made in the Rajya Sabha. On international page here, you have the same news about Sri Lanka we have already discussed. Mahinda Rajapaksa has been made the Prime Minister. So brother is the President, Gotabaya, and Mahinda is the Prime Minister of Sri Lanka now. And Netanyahu, this is in Israel. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, he has been indicted for fraud, bribery and breach of trust. So these are the charges against him. Country will be in a deep political crisis now. And this is China releases UK embassy workers video. So this is Simon Cheng, whose photo has been released. So video has been released. So Cheng says in the video that he made filmed confession to soliciting prostitution under pressure. So this is there. And below you again have same US elections and impeachment, Trump impeachment procedure going on, which the Democrats have initiated. And UK also will see elections, so Labour Party making its promises. That all is fine. So important news here is regarding Israel and China. On business page, you have loans worth 2.52 lakh crores disbursed in October 2019. So this is what central government has said. So in public sector banks outreach, corporates get almost half of the total loans. MSMEs also got a major chunk. So this is what the government is saying, that to boost the economy, credit is being provided, loans are being provided. And this is BSNL rings in 7,500 crore loss in first half of the financial year, you can see. So this is the loss which public sector company, telecom company BSNL has announced. And this is Airtel may shed more debt ahead of fresh bids. So new tender for privatization is planned, but before that it may sell off some assets and reduce its debt, which is, you can see, half of the loan amount of 58,000 crore has been transferred to a special purpose vehicle. It may try to reduce its debt. And this is new investments in financial year 2020 fall to 15-year low. So government share in such projects dropped to 36% now in financial year 2019 from 56% in financial year 2015. So this is the CARE rating agency stating so, that new investments are falling. Even government share of investments have fallen. And below you have moratorium on spectrum dues may not help telcos. So industry is asked for rationalization of taxes and levies. So only delaying the payment as such is not going to help, is what has been stated. So these are the important headlines. The last page has sports news. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.